From the centre of the UK City of Culture 2021, this is BBC Coventry and Warwickshire.
Pink, it's BBC Coventry and Warwickshire. It's a Friday night, later on featuring Reggae Got Soul. We're getting into the Friday night vibe here, and we're going to get into the chat very soon. I've got my mates in the studio, and tonight I'm joined by Shirley and Andre. How are you guys?
Awesome, how are you?
I'm good.
I'm very well, thank you, Dave. That's nice to brilliant. See you again, apart from my throat, which is a little bit hoarse.
Andre, I want to start with you just to tell us a little bit about yourself, because I've never met you before.
No, that's true. We met literally a few minutes ago as we just walked in. So, yeah, my name's Andre. Yeah. I teach guitar. I am now the self-styled mind music mentor. I have some very interesting views about music. I think it's going to come through in the 21st century. Right. It hasn't before. With things like Alzheimer's and also particularly with internet addiction. And we're becoming a very visual society, so I think music's going to come through. But also do teach some guitar and also help workshops and help people build their confidence to play and perform in front of audiences. So that's really what I do.
That is really cool. And is it more electric or acoustic stuff?
It tends to be both, but what sometimes happens is people think they start on acoustic guitar, but when they get a bit more confident, all of a sudden they start getting towards the electric guitar. And you do get some people who just start out from electric guitar, because the build and quality of electric guitars are really good now, and it's not like you have to start on acoustic how it was years ago. Mm. So a bit of both, really.
Yeah, you might be impressed to know that one of my Christmas presents was a Fender Telecaster.
Oh, we're very impressed.
Oh, we are.
A white Telecaster.
Oh, fantastic.
Anyway, enough about me. I'm quite excited that I've got two musicians with me. Because straight after this, we're going to be talking about
inspiration. I've never been called a musician before.
Oh, yeah,
so
you're a musician.
I am really.
I haven't been called a singer either.
You guys are musicians. I'm a bluesician.
A bluesician?
Yes.
Ooh.
My mates are in the studio, Shirley and Andre. And tonight is also Burns Night, which is named after Scottish poet Robbie Burns. And coincidentally, it was announced today that the poet Deborah Ulmer is preparing to open the UK's first poetry... the UK's first poetry pharmacy. Poetry pharmacy in Shropshire. Now, poetry pharmacy? Guys, you're musicians. Do you ever turn to music or poetry for inspiration, for help? Now, Mr. Guitar Man, Andre.
Guitar Man? Funny you say that, because I was the worst guitar student ever at the age of 7, so I have to laugh when you say that.
But you started young at 7?
Well, kind of, yeah. Okay. I started very, very young at 7, and the first year was a complete disaster. I think partly because it was the wrong kind of music. But getting back to your question about, this whole thing about music and as a pharmacy, I think with me, it was kind of, music has always been the thing that I go to, but not necessarily always lyrics, just the music. Because as a youngster, I was really shy. And I know people sometimes find that a bit hard to believe, because I've helped a lot of people play on stage, and I'm going to be up to about 1,000 performance videos by 2020.
Okay.
But that was my big thing. You know, whether it was at school or in social situations, if I felt uncomfortable or whatever, I'd always somehow get back to music, whether it was listening or just picking up a guitar with a few chords that I did know. So I guess it, like with a lot of people, is sort of the soundtrack of your life, whatever it was that you grew up with. And with me, it was kind of indie, new wave, punk rock. That was that kind of stuff. As I moved on from that, I got into sort of blues and rock styles and some kind of slow ballad things.
Yeah.
And yeah, music, without question, is a massive way to shift the mood of the mind. It's interesting when I talk to people about music, and particularly people who don't play, they'll always say, oh, I've heard of the Mozart effect, and I like listening to music. I'm like, hang on. It's not just Mozart, it's whatever you're into. Yeah. And, you know, there was a musicologist guy, John Sloboda, he did some research around time of the Mozart effect. And it was, like Shirley was saying, it's that music from your soundtrack that massively can shift people. And there's documented scientific proof on this now. But I think we're really getting into the era where more and more people are going to be playing music.
Yeah.
And that's where it's going to be going, particularly as technology starts to take off even more so.
Now, as a guitarist, Andre, obviously you deal with a lot of chords.
Sure.
Playing chords. And what gets me sometimes with music is that harmony.
Right.
If you're playing chords and a chord progression, the way it moves from bar to bar,
yes.
The sound.
Yes.
That often gets me. Psychologically, sometimes I feel something when I hear a nice chord structure.
Sure. I mean, there's different reasons as to why this is. I mean, it depends on what kind of style you're playing. If you're playing like a sort of what I call playing... chords around the campfire than we do certain types of chords across the first three frets. Mm. But there is a technique called voice leading. Goes way back. I mean, Shirley was talking about sort of religious and spiritual music, because those origins of music goes way back to, you know, when merry monks, you maybe get four people singing a harmony and just one note would change at a time.
That's right.
And I think that's where I love, and particularly with some of the guys who are not necessarily hitting all the bar chords and the rock stuff, it's just moving that one note and just radically shifts the whole emotion. You can really feel it. Like Shirley was saying, you can feel it in the heart and the soul.
Yeah, yeah. So here's a bit like the plain song sort of stuff.
Oh, yeah. So, I mean, neuroscience says nothing uses more of the brain than music, but it really is not just the brain thing. It's a brain, heart, soul thing, without question in my mind.
That's brilliant.
Well, I mean, music has always been in my life. I've loved listening, gone through the whole, you know, since I was a child, the Beatles, they, you know, have that effect on you. When you're growing up.
That's your soundtrack. Well, even that advanced Alzheimer's sufferers. I mean, that was my big breakthrough in 2013, because I was telling Shirley, one of the questions I asked was, how can I inspire people to practice guitar more? Because if you're a music educator, you know what happens. You do a great lesson and they come back and say, didn't have time to practice. And we know it's not about time poverty, it's about time priority. So I asked the question, how can we inspire people? And 2013 discovered advanced Alzheimer's sufferers, music from the soundtrack of their lives, waking up and literally being able to communicate again. I mean, that was incredible. And at the other end of the scale, which people aren't aware of, you've got US Navy SEALs, you know, do really tough training. On their toughest training in Hell Week, they are now investigating singing to increase their resilience. So it works across the whole spectrum in ways we don't really understand fully, I don't believe.
Right, okay. But I hit 55 the other day, a few weeks ago. And I'd like, if
you're
I was
looking
still
good
around,
on it.
Yeah, I'm looking very good.
If I was still around in 20 years, say, if I was age 75 and I'd like to cycle, knowing that there was a bike that was catering for me, I think that'd
you'd
be
go
pretty
for it.
Cool. Yeah.
Would you sell your guitar though for that?
Ooh.
now we're into a dilemma now. Guitar or cycle? You
I'd
decide.
I'd do both. I'd take the guitar on the I'd play.
You'd play and cycle. Well, that'd be for a circus, like
I'd
a unicycle.
Cool, yeah. The coolest 75.
It would be, man. I want to buy a ticket now.
Guys, this has been interesting.
Yeah.
Shirley, thanks for popping in.
Oh, yes.
And don't leave it so long.
I won't.
It's been ages.
It has been. It's too long. Yes.
And
too long.
Thanks for coming in.
No,
thanks for letting me diss your jumper.
No. You go ahead. You diss away.
And it's been great talking to my musician friends.
Well, I love being called a musician.
That's been awesome. Thanks very much.
Brilliant.